Hi, this is Marcus. I'm going to be demonstrating a new application called Plex, which is a multimedia application for the Apple computer. It's for the also for the iPad and for the iPhone, and this application is free. So let's just go ahead and get started with this. Plex is an application which allows you to have your digital multimedia hub, and that's one of these big fancy words for your music, your videos, different applications and things you're running which are multimedia. You can display it and actually see it within this application. Now there is an application which I have to mention that comes with Apple called Front Row, and I'm going to use my remote control that I have with this, so you won't see anything moving around the screen. But I'll go ahead and start up my remote and I'll quit this here so we can quit it, and then I'm going to start up the Front Row. And what Front Row allows you to do is this is a thing that's actually built in Apple, and it lets you do your movies, your TV shows, and basically you can watch it on your system because Apple has a full high-def screen with a computer. So for instance, if I went into my movies, if I have any movies, it'll show me the movies that's at the that are at the theater, so I can watch trailers if I wanted to. I could go ahead and pick a trailer to watch and actually click on this, and it will stream the trailer from the internet, and I can watch, you know, see what's going on with the movies.
You're that guy running for Senate,
pretty much see how that works.
I am that guy, yeah.
So let me go ahead and stop this, put this back out, go back out to this. You have TV shows, music, podcasts. If you have any podcasts, I have a podcast that I've created, and I can play this by doing that. You have photos. If you have any photos in here, you can do shirt photos and different things like that. And this is your settings. This is Front Row. But what I'm going to do right now is show you the application Plex, which is a kick-ass is what I want to say. So let's go ahead and say it. And it also operates from a remote control. So what I'm doing right now, but it does a little bit more than the Front Row. You can do movies, you can do TV shows, but there's other things that you can do as well. Like for video plugins, I can go into here and it shows me these are internet applications, or not application, but internet websites that do streaming video. So for instance, for CNET, I can go into CNET and it's starting it up, and they have things on CNET that you can actually do. You know, for instance, I can see what's going on, what product to purchase if I was looking for something like that. I can look at the tech shows. You can go on Apple Bytes, and they'll go in, and there's different things on the iPad to show you how to use certain things. If I click on this right now, it'll stream and come right on.
What's up, Brian Tong here, and welcome to the Apple Byte for all the good and bad stuff inside the...
I stop, bring it back out, go back out to different things. You got, you know, different things you can go into. You got little hacks, things to show you how to, you know, how to get into, you know, how to break into Gmail, how to, you know, how to do certain things. They got how-tos, which are training videos and stuff, which are free. You know, how to save in web photos to your iPad. How to make calls from Gmail, and all these kind of things. If I hit this right here, it'll take you right into it. And this application is free. It doesn't cost any extra money. So you're able to do this for no problem.
Hello everyone, I'm Jessica Delcourt with CNET, here to show you how to get started making phone calls from right within gmail.com.
Now you can actually go to these applications on your computer and do that, but what this does is centralize it to where everything is right
your
here.
Gmail.
If I go back, you have different things you can go to. You have, you know, this is another one called TED Talks, which, you know, talks about certain things. Fem date, dated fam. This will stream as well. And you go and you choose what you wanted to. If there was something that was interesting, you would hit this.
Yeah.
And they're adding more stuff as we talk about it right now. So it's pretty good. As for ideals, if I go to this right here, what that'll do is let me adjust the volume.
Julian, welcome. It's been reported that WikiLeaks.
Go to here, I can adjust my colors.
In the last few years,
go in here and start playing with things, you know.
Documents than the rest of the world's,
you know, you can start customizing however you do things.
Can it possibly be true? It's a worry, isn't it, that the rest of the world's media is doing such a bad job that a little.
And you go back. There are some other things they have here. They have this right here. Can you watch stations? Feature stations. You know, they have Adobe beginning classes, and this is very good here for people that are getting into Photoshop. You know, you want to get into Photoshop or something else by Adobe, and you know, like Photoshop Elements or something like that, and you get into it and you just want to get something to get you started, and you go out and buy books, but the books are using jargon that you don't quite understand, and people want to show you, but then they want to charge you a lot of money for it. For people just getting started, what I'm trying to do with a lot of the things that I'm doing as far as with the blog pages and everything else is make the information available and try to build a community where things can be shared amongst people to increase the creativity. That's, you know, one of my goals of what I would like to do. But anyway, if we go back into this here, they have all kind of different application things that you can learn. So if you go into, if you go down for the Adobe, they got different classes that you can go into. So if you click this one, you know, so what is this one here? Creating, this is using Premiere, their video program, Premiere 4, if you were using for video. You could go into this one. This one is the effects program. This one's Sound Booth. Let's go into this here. And again, these courses are free on the internet. Most people don't know where they're at and don't know how to get to them. And what this does is centralize these things for you.
Inside of Adobe Premiere Pro CS4, and I wanted to spend a few moments talking.
So you can use this for video classes. They have things like, especially a lot of people that are going to photography. I have a few friends that ask me photography stuff. I spent over $10,000 for training and equipment and everything I got for photography. And I've been doing it on an intense level for about the last 6 or 7 years. So I would consider myself a semi-pro, right up at a pro level as far as photography. And so a lot of things I've, you know, learned, I've got books and videos and a whole lot of things that actually were, I obtained different techniques and different procedures on how to do things. But these things were not available when I first got into photography. You had to go out and you just had to decipher through it, and it was just based upon dedication. If you were dedicated enough, you find information you want. But now, I mean, what type of lens to use? Man, 6 years ago, this information would have been key for me picking the right camera. Not going through so many different cameras. How to do metering of your lighting, and how to do, you know, this right here shows you, you know, this guy's got 30 plus years and doing photography, and it's showing you how to brainstorm different things. So let me just go ahead and find something that's pretty interesting. Let's go with this, right? This is part of talking about lighting. Let's go ahead and hit this here.
Adorama TV presents How They Do That, where we explore the world of professional photographers and share their techniques with you. Here's your host, Mark Wallace.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to this week's episode of How'd They Do That. My name is Mark Wallace. Well, normally on this show, we feature professional photographers, but this week we're going to break our rule and feature a photographer named Ken Peterson. Now, Ken is a weekend shooter. He shoots weeknights. He shoots product. He shoots all kinds of still.
And they have just so many different things that you can actually, that you can get into. Different applications, different videos you can watch. They have stuff for entertainment. It just ain't all about computer, you know, just doing computer stuff. You got entertainment stuff that you can do. They have stuff, game shows, old shows, and a whole bunch of other things. But this application is extremely good. I really like it, and like I said, it's free. So if you have a Macintosh system, you have to get this. I mean, because at some point they're going to start charging for it. But this lets you access your front row, so I can actually access my front row directly from there and go back into what I was in before. And I can get out of this and go back out. And it'll take me back to my desktop. So this is a very good application, and it takes me right back to the Plex application here. They have different things with preferences, and you know, you can change your theme or your skin. As you can see at the bottom, there's things that are streaming live on from the internet. You have appearances and videos and a whole lot of stuff about Plex. I would recommend downloading. Thanks a lot for watching, and I hope the information that I've put out has been useful. Thank you.